Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome to a new video with me, Fuzzball40. If you are new around here, subscribe down below. You get two trading videos a day. And if you go and watch yesterday's video, as long as you're subscribed, go and edit the giveaway on yesterday morning's video. It was part of our £50 giveaway for reaching 1,000 subscribers. It's a £10 gift card as part of that giveaway. So go and give that a watch after this video. But yeah, this video is going to be basically a trading video on you guys to sort of tell you what will happen from 6 o'clock onwards when it all drops. So I'm pretty sure it's 6 o'clock anyway. But when the team of the year starts and stuff like that. But I cannot say this strongly enough. Please do not spend FIFA points. This company deserves nothing from us. I buy the game, and that's what you're getting from me. If you look at my screen right now, I finished Gold 2 this week, right? And legitimately, it's not sour grapes. There were 4 or 5 games where I was utterly outplayed by my opponent, full stop. There were 5 or 6 games where it was utterly unplayable. The servers were terrible. The game was delayed. In five of those six games, my opponents had 2 shots or less. I had 8 shots or more, and they won. They won it. I had Messi missing open goals, but Aguero missing open goals. Players unable to pass, stuck in the mud, gliding on screen. You know when the ball gets passed and they sort of glide backwards like idiots. Like, it's just don't spend money. If they're not willing to spend the money we're spending on this game to improve it, then don't spend money on the game. Use these trading tips instead. I can't implore you enough to just use these trading tips. Forget everything that they want you to do tomorrow with whatever Lightlands want. I'll make coins from what they do. Make coins from their greed. Their insatiable greed for money, 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 money. And nothing back for the community. Nothing at all. Use their greed against them and make coins instead tomorrow. I can't implore that enough. But in order for you guys to not spend FIFA points, I've got to give you guys as many good tips as I can give you. I'm going to base everything off of all the promos we've had so far this year and all the promo and how team of the year went to last year, okay? So, getting into this video, 6 o'clock, content drops. The first thing you want to be thinking about is what has dropped, okay? So you want to be going to your squad battle building challenges. And obviously, for the last 3 days, EA has starved us for content. I'm surprised by that, because normally they'd coin sync us, but I think maybe they've shown a degree of heart. That tiny little, we've all got normal big hearts like this. EA got a heart this big, just sort of sat there. And they thought, we'll be nice for once. We won't be utter, nasty, vile human beings. So that's fine. What you need to think about here is what content dropped. And there's a chance, there's rumour about Marcelo's team flashback. If you've seen yesterday evening's video, you'll see all the leaks that came out. But look at the content and say, right, is this going to be popular content? So one thing you're always certainly going to get is a daily SBC, possibly some flash SBCs, but usually daily SBCs, 4 packs. So it might be a gold players pack, it might be whatever pack it is. That's one thing. We'll talk about that in a second. What you want to be looking at, initially for me, I look at player SBCs. If they brought out a player SBC, so for example, if that Marcelo comes out, in my opinion, it will be incredibly popular. So I'm looking at going, okay, cool, what are the requirements? Okay, so I look at Marcelo and it's got a Real Madrid requirement, a 86 rated squad as part of that, maybe a Brazilian requirement with an 85 rated squad, maybe an 87 rated squad with a team of the week in it, XYZ. I then go and buy players based upon that, because what happens is at 6 o'clock is we get lightning rounds. We get lightning rounds and basically loads of people open up packs after packs after packs after packs. And what will happen in that period is the players will drop in price. Everyone that comes out drops in price. And then once the lightning round's over, they rise. And so you make instant profit right there. So what we're doing on Black Friday, we're buying SBC fodder for maybe 4 or 5K below what it actually was. So what you want to do right now is go and check the market on your console and say, okay, how much is Rakitic selling for right now? There's no reason for him to be, so you've got to think, right, he's selling for 15K. The only thing holding this price up is base icon SBC, which will still be there. So you think, right, but in these lightning rounds, if I can buy him at 10, 11K, he should rise to at least 14, 15 again. But if a big SBC comes out, a big player SBC comes out, he's going to climb. So that's what I would do. I look at the SBC first, player SBC, and say, okay, cool, what is going on there? How do I best make coins? Bang. Get straight in there and start bidding those players, buying those players. But you have the opportunity to snipe them at the beginning of the lightning round. And then remember, an hour later, the bids come round. Go and bid on them after that. So then bid on them at lower prices and whatnot and try and get as low as you can to then try and resell again straight away. So people doing the SBCs. Massively important that you do that. Then we look at like the daily SBC, right? Is the daily SBC good? What are the requirements? Is it all gold players? Okay, cool. EA have a habit, because again, they're not very nice people, of making the requirements utterly ridiculous and stupid. Like a rare Romanian player, like idiots. Legitimate idiots. It'll be like a rare squad with Romanian players, so you've only got 2 or 3 to choose from. You look at that and go, okay, cool. What do I need from this? Brazilian, they might need 2 Brazilian players. Okay, cool. I'm gonna invest in Brazilian players. But this is where right now you could be making coins right now, is if you're investing for those SBCs in non-rare goals at discard price from major leagues. The 5 major leagues, non-rare goals at discard price. What you want to do then, the moment SBC comes out, is put them on the market. Have a look at what they're selling for, put them on the market, and you'll make double your coins back from each of those cards, guaranteed. So that's what you want to be thinking about there. What you then want to be thinking about is, okay, cool, I've bought these cards, I've bought these players, I've done whatever it is I've got to do. Now how best do I start making even more coins? And then my advice to you here is to look at what is happening with the market. So now you start looking at the market, you start saying, okay, cool, there is a bounce back here. However, if I've got players in my team that I'm seeing a crash in, and they might drop off, I might sell at that point and see what happens. I will tell you now that last year at the end of the team of the year, the whole market went down. So if you've got players you're sitting on right now that are a meta of value and whatnot, you're waiting selling them, sell them. Get them sold. Just after lightning rounds when they all climb back and bounce back again. But just monitor the market and see what it's doing. But so remember, the first two things you've got are the player SBCs that are coming out and the daily SBCs that come out. They're your first two chances to make coins, okay? The first two chances to make coins, and that's right on the periphery tomorrow. So sniping SBC fodder and that, and team of the weeks as well. If you need team of the weeks, snipe those team of the weeks at that point. During lightning rounds, they'll drop off massively. But remember, throughout the whole period, there's going to be loads of packs being opened. So team of the week sniping is effective as anything. People want to clear it out. During Black Friday, I was picking up Bergwijn's and Kimmich's 10, 15k in Kimmich's case, and maybe 7 or 8k in Bergwijn's case, under their value. I was making 5 or 6k a card. It was ridiculous. It was so, so good. So think about that. It's something you can definitely be looking at in a way of making coins. But you do that. Now you've got to think again, what else might EA release during this period? Okay, cool. You know I'm a big guy with League SBC trading. I love League SBC trading, and it's still very effective in Team of the Year because as part of the pack rewards, EA have been viral in what they've done this year with SBCs. But player SBC rewards probably won't be rare player packs like it should be, or jumbo rare player packs. They're probably going to be silver packs and bronze packs. That's your chance to buy, to hold, invest, and then resell. Remember that. Don't forget the League SBC investing still exists. And just look at this. There's going to be a lot more packs being opened. There's going to be rare election packs on the market. But right now, if you're sat on League SBC players, I'm going to be doing this on stream today. Clear them out. Clear your club out. Get it gutted of all of those players. Even if on somebody you're taking a loss, just get it gutted. Get it cleared out. So you start afresh on Team of the Year, ready to go, knowing what is in your club, what coins you've got to trade with, and set yourself a budget of what you want to make and how you're going to make it, and plan out everything. So at 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock lightning rounds, how am I going to make coins? And it happens every lightning round. Make sure you're bidding on stuff. So what you want to do is 6 o'clock lightning round, you want to snipe. 7 o'clock, you want to be bidding and sniping. 8 o'clock, bidding and sniping into that. Remember, different things change at different times for it. I don't know if there are flash SPCs. If there are flash SPCs, be hot on them. There's a lot of coins. What else you want to be doing, right? So I told you guys about the league SPCs, not league SPCs, the player SPCs and the daily SPCs. Those daily SPCs are a gold mine if you use Footbin. If you go to Footbin and check solutions, you can see that, for example, they won't be here now, but let's say, for example, this one comes out and it's the Footbin solution. It's the daily SPC. Go on Footbin and look at the solutions. Look at what the solutions are saying on Footbin. And if on Footbin you're seeing, okay, cool, this is asking for rare, this one's got rare Switzerland bronze players, go and buy them. Go and snipe them. People won't realise they're cheap, and people will pick them up because people are lazy. People don't want to do it themselves, so they'll look at Footbin and go, right, let me find a solution. And they'll do it for 10k when they could have done it for 5k. And that 5k extra they're doing it for is profit that you're making because you put those coins on, you put those cards on the market. So that's that's definitely your friend. Other things you want to think about in this situation is there have been leaks of Marcelo, Pogba, Neuer, and Iniesta. We don't know how true they are. I'd wager that a couple are. One big thing you can do in this situation is link investing. So if Marcelo gets a team of the year card, like a flashback, Varane will link to him. Varane will link to him, and he'll there's a chance he'll go up in price slightly because people want to use him. Or Brazilian players will link to him. Or Neymar will link to him. Things like Pogba, Kante links to him, and Martial links to him. Think about those sort of things and just have a little look. And you haven't got to do it rash. There's no need to be very quick on it and go, okay, cool, I'm going to snap onto it. But you can just go, hang on, let me have a look at what's going on in the market. Oh, there is a slight rise here. Maybe it's worth me investing in one or two and see what happens. That's something you can be doing. Final thing to talk about is rash investing. Now, this, don't panic invest, but rash investing is different than that. What rash investing is seeing the requirements and then going out and buying those players specifically. So, for example, if the player SBCs, people are pre-investing right now. They said to me they're going to pre-invest, and that's on you guys, and good luck. I hope to God that you do well on that. But people are pre-investing in players for the leaks and doing that. But say the player SBC comes out, look at the requirements and go and snipe specific players for those requirements. So if it's Brazilian players, go and snipe specifically a Brazilian player that links and fits the meta. So let's say, for example, Casemiro comes out, Marcelo comes out, and he requires Real Madrid Brazilians. in separate squads, Casemiro is going to become a sort of a lot more difficult to get hold of because he fits both criteria and people will be using him for both criteria. So that's when you go, right, I'm going to invest in him because that's those sort of cars that end up extinct on the market, you can make a lot of coins out of. So they're the ones you want to be thinking about in terms of rash investing and go, okay, cool, that's what it requires. Or if, for example, Iniesta comes out and it requires Spanish players from Barcelona, Busquets might suddenly become extinct and whatnot, and Piqué, those sort of cards, you'll see that they'll be the ones to go and invest in. But that's to give you a rough idea of what happens at 6 o'clock and how you can best make coins. Don't forget League SBC still methods still exist. It's a good one to make. But lads, I hope that video helped you out. Please, I implore you, do not buy FIFA points. Just trade instead. Subscribe down below if you're new around here. Drop a like on the video. You get 2 videos a day. The uploads for the evenings will be later probably, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the stuff on stream that we're doing on stream. Then we'll do a video on what we did on stream at that time. And then I'll show you how many coins we'll be making and the budget I'll start off with and where we end up. But for now, lads, I'm out. Peace out. Have a good day. See the year starts at 6 o'clock. Let's do this.